Hey, good morning, boys and girls. I hope you are doing well. It is so good to get a chance to be with you as we continue to look at the new City Catechism. And I wanted to just bring something up real quick. As you guys know, we've been working on this for a few months now. And did you know that today is our 20th question and answer? Wow, this will be the 20th one of these that we've done. And, you know, one of the interesting things I think that we've seen over the last few weeks is that we've gotten a chance to understand a bit more about who God is, about His holiness and how He works in the world, about our condition, our sinful condition. And, you know, some of that doesn't always feel like good news. Well, today, we're going to begin to make a shift. We're going to begin to make a change. And it really helps us to see a bit more. Hopefully, we're going to see more about how this gets personal to us. And we're going to learn more about the role of Jesus. So let me ask the question and answer. And then I have something very special to show you today. All right. So our question for today is, who is the Redeemer? Who is the Redeemer? If you remember last week, Miss Tammy brought up this idea of a Redeemer. And what we're going to learn today is that the Redeemer, the only Redeemer, is the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, you might be thinking, well, what in the world is a Redeemer? Well, let me help us understand it a little bit this way. Have you ever owed somebody anything? Have you ever owed somebody money? You know, your parents, you desperately wanted something and your mom and dad said, okay, but you have to pay us back for it. And of course, you know, most of your money comes from mom and dad anyways. So Zoe worked up a really cute little video this week. And I think it's helpful for us to understand how to think about this. So check out this video and then I'll be right back and we'll talk about it a bit more.
Give me the money. I don't have it.
You have 1 week.
Okay.
You don't have my money?
This is all I have.
So did that help you understand a little bit more? So here's this guy. He owes somebody else money. And he tells the guy who is owed the money, the one who lent it, said, hey, I want my money back. The guy just didn't have it. Well, many, many years ago, when people didn't have money to pay, they would be sent to prison until they could pay the debt. Now, think about this for a second. If you're in prison, how are you going to pay the debt? You're never going to pay. It's always going to be there. You will never get rid of this debt. And so that's one of the challenges we have, is that as people, as humans, we have this sin problem. And in many ways, it's like we're already in this jail of this human body that likes to sin. And so we have this challenge. So we're constantly in this prison, in this debt we're trying to pay back, and yet we can never fully pay back because all of our good deeds fall short. All of our goodness is there, which is why we need a Redeemer. We need someone who can help us out. We need someone who can free us. And we believe, we know from Scripture that Jesus Christ is the only Redeemer. 1 Timothy 2:5 says, for there is one God, and there is one mediator between God and man, the man Jesus Christ. So you see, this mediator is there to help us, and this mediator is there to pay our debt on our behalf. You know, when I showed you Zoe's video just a few moments ago, I cut out part of it. Let's watch it again, but this time let's watch the whole thing.
Give me the money. I don't have it.
You have 1 week.
Okay.
You don't have my money?
This is all I have.
You're free to go.
But how?
I'm needs you to feed prisoner Eddie. Why did you save me? I wanted to pay the price to save you, like how Jesus paid the price to save me.
So boys and girls, we've seen that our sin has consequences. We've seen that God, in his holiness, has to judge rightly. But we have also been learning that out of God's grace, he has provided a redeemer for us. And that redeemer is Jesus Christ. Just like that man in Zoe's video got to be freed from prison, so you and I get to be freed from the consequences of our sin because of Jesus Christ. Because of what Jesus Christ has done, there's only one way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So we need a redeemer, because God in his justice has to punish our sin. So either we pay for it for eternity, or the redeemer helps us out. And in this case, Jesus Christ did that, and his salvation is available to all who will receive it. So question 20, one more time, who is the redeemer? The answer, the only redeemer is the Lord Jesus Christ. And over the next several weeks, we're going to get to consider more about who Jesus is and what he has done, and how, as our Redeemer, he saves us and helps us to live in that. But I hope that you will get to rejoice with me for all that we have because of our Redeemer, Jesus Christ. Let's pray together. God, we do thank you so much for being the holy and just God that you are. Thank you for seeing our sin and helping us to see our sin the way that we should, as an offense to you, as a way where we have violated your commands. But God, thank you for recognizing our desperate need for a redeemer. Lord, you know we can't pay the debt of our sin on our own, and we need someone to save us from that. So Lord, thank you for sending your only son, Jesus Christ, to be our redeemer. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, you guys have a great week.